Phelps, Bukowski, you have a new case. Two women, possible drink drive.
How is that a case?
The broad says she was doped and that somebody tried to kill her.
Where did this take place?
That's the bit you're gonna love. Right across the street.
What?
A Chevy Styline took a nosedive off the escarpment, fetched up underneath a Cola King billboard. Up to it, boys. We got bad guys to catch.
Yeah, the bum took a swipe at me. Put him down with my sap.
See you later, fellas. Try not to work too hard.
Look at you, Bantham, look at you. There's a tear to my eye watching my caterpillar go.
I'm just trying to fit in. Educated, hardworking, straight as an arrow. I hate to break it to you, Cole, but you'll never fit in the Central.
Him, the cop from the papers.
Stop just ahead. Her face looks familiar.
Well, that's June Ballard, Tarzan's sister, Beast of the Amazon. She's married to Guy McAfee. The captain has moved to Vegas now, but the two of them still have juice.
Phelps, traffic.
Detective Phelps. Hey, Bukowski. Long time no see.
You could have called this in by megaphone, Enrique. Phelps, this is Enrique Gonzalez. Enrique was a pretty decent middleweight.
What do we have, Gonzalez?
Broad drives right through the empty lot and off the side of the escarpment. Her story's that a movie producer doped her and her friend and sent the car over the cliff.
Was anyone hurt?
Driver's beat up. Not too bad, considering. If she hadn't hit that billboard, we'd be scraping both of them off the pavement. Passenger's a Jessica Hamilton. She's just a kid. Pretty knocked around.
Kid gonna be all right?
I think so. They've taken her to central receiving. If you want to take a look around, stall the ambulance.
Thanks. Do that.
One more thing. Watch out for the driver. She cuts rough.
This ain't the red carpet, so get out of my lens.
If you're looking for the coroner, he's down by the crash site.
You'll want to see this, Phelps. There, laid out on the trunk. And that isn't even the best part.
Looks like they're lucky they weren't more badly injured.
Must have been unconscious. Being relaxed tends to lessen the soft tissue damage.
They've been torn off. Where did you find them?
They were stuffed in the young lady's handbag. I'll run a trace for semen when I get back to the lab.
She's a long way from home. Drunk driver?
Maybe not.
How so?
Well, a head I found without a body piqued my interest. See what you think.
Alas, poor Yorick. I knew him, Horatio.
Is it real?
No. I think it's supposed to be a replica of an Indian shrunken head. It's some kind of curio or movie prop. See the casting marks?
What's it made from?
Plaster of Paris would be my first guess, then painted.
So we can rule out the murder angle?
No, you can rule that in. That thing was wedging the accelerator to the floor. Whoever did it wanted these women dead.
How
How does someone manage to tip their ride straight off a cliff? If the driver's in a fit state, we should ask.
Mrs. McAfee, we would like to ask you a few questions, if that's okay.
I prefer to use my maiden name, June Ballard. You might be familiar with some of my work.
Can you tell us what happened here?
You're kind of cute for a cop. Maybe a bit on the serious side.
What about me, June? I'm a big fan of Beast of...
I don't like. Keep out of this.
We understand that you're still suffering from the effects of the accident, Mrs. McAfee. The officer says that you claimed that you were drugged. Who did this to you?
That rat slipped us a Mickey Finn. It's no wonder I feel so dopey. I can't remember.
It's a serious offense to withhold information from the police during a criminal investigation, madam.
I told you to call me June. You're making me feel like an old lady. And don't bother your handsome head about this. My husband will settle the score with Mark Bishop.
What can you tell us about the passenger in your car?
Jessica Hamilton. Poor Jessica. It's been a rough day for her. She's desperate to break into movies. What more can I say?
I think you're lying, Mrs. McAfee. I think something happened to Jessica yesterday before the crash.
I'm offended, Sunshine. Do you have any proof?
Miss Hamilton's underwear were physically torn from her body.
She wanted to go to a casting. I took her to a casting. Whatever happened after that is between her and Mark Bishop.
We found a shrunken head. It was used to tamper with your car.
You see, I normally don't drive off cliffs. The last thing I remember is getting behind the wheel.
It's obviously some kind of movie prop. You must know where it came from.
In case you hadn't noticed, I am the talent. And the talent doesn't deal with props or sets or any of that kind of stuff. Why don't you ask Mark Bishop which prop house he uses?
You mentioned a Mark Bishop. You think he might have had something to do with this?
He is a movie producer. As for his involvement, you just leave it to me and my husband to worry about.
I want to know what happened between you two that made him want to commit a double murder.
Bishop offered me a part in his picture. Then he withdrew it. Fact is, we had a deal. I pressed him on it. And this is where I end up.
Mrs. McAfee, I think it would be in everyone's best interest if you accompanied Patrolman Gonzalez back to the receiving hospital.
I'm going to be okay. These guys can take me home after. My lawyer and I have talked to the news hounds.
Mrs. McAfee, you are still under the influence of narcotics, and you're likely to go into shock once the drugs wear off.
And I thought you were a heel. It's nice of you to be concerned.
I think we're good here. Let's go see what we can shake out of the kid.
I heard this is a triple homicide.
Victim has regained consciousness at Central Receiving Hospital.
11K Roger, en route.
Detective Phelps, here to interview a Jessica Hamilton.
Jessica Hamilton? Oh, yes. She's in the room right behind you, Detective.
You can't hold me here. No.
Feeling better since this morning, Jessica?
By a doctor. I need my lawyer.
My head still feels
fine. Where is the telephone? Do you know who I am?
Hello, Jessica. My name is Cole Phelps. I'm a policeman. I'd like to talk to you about your accident, if that's okay.
Okay.
Can you tell me what you remember about the crash?
It's all kind of fuzzy. I remember waking up here. Nothing happened yesterday.
Tell the truth, Jessica. Why the big cover-up?
I'm not lying to you.
We found your underwear and your handbag, Jessica. You need to tell us what happened.
The doctor told me what happened. I didn't want that. I just wanted to be a star, to be in movies. I told Junie what happened, and she told me to toughen up. But that was the price of stardom.
Did she now, cold-hearted bitch?
It's not Junie's fault. It's not my first time. I had a boyfriend back home, but my father found out about him.
Even if you consented, Jessica, you're still underage. We need to get in touch with your parents, Jessica, to tell them what has happened.
Oh, you don't need to worry them. They sent me along to stay with Aunt June. They trust her to take care of me.
You're lying, Jessica. How are we going to make this right if you lie to us?
Please, Detective, why would I lie to you?
Because you're a runaway, Jessica, and you don't have your parents' permission to be here. Now, do you want to tell me what really happened?
I went with Junie to this strange place. It's difficult to remember. Someone gave me a drink to calm my nerves, and then I felt faint. I think I must have passed out.
How did you meet Mr. Bishop?
Well, Junie is a big movie star. You probably know that. She's doing a new movie.
What's the story with Bishop and Mrs. McAfee? Why does he want the two of you dead?
That can't be true. Mr. Bishop seemed very happy today. I mean, yesterday.
And that's why he wedged a shrunken head against the accelerator pedal and punted the two of you over an escarpment?
I overheard Junie speaking to him on the phone a couple of times. Screaming, really. She can be very hard sometimes, Junie. But they seemed okay yesterday, like they worked it out.
I know what happened to you, Jessica. Where exactly did it take place?
Please, it's scary. It's really difficult to think of anything.
Jessica, I really need you to help me here.
I remember the mermaid.
Was the mermaid in the movie too?
No, it was on the front of a building. We pulled up in front of the mermaid.
Thank you, Jessica. You've been a big help. Here's my card. If you think of anything or you need some help, just get in touch, okay?
Okay.
I think it might be a good idea if you went back home till you felt better, Jessica.
I couldn't do that, officer. What if I got the part and I wasn't there?
It's the tale of this town, Cole. Lambs that go willingly to slaughter. Who the hell is that?
Must be her lawyer. He certainly expedited her release.
I don't like it, Cole. Why is she in such a hurry? We should follow her. There she goes. Come on.
Thank you. Ballard is definitely up to something. She seems to have made a remarkably speedy recovery. Get in there and see what she's up to.
Cougars all around, you know.
No, I don't want him taught a lesson. You know what I want. Well, then make someone else do it. You still know people out here, don't you? Then make some calls. I'm going to be very clear about this. You get this done, or I'm... Wilson's Hotel. Mr. Mark Bishop, that son of a bitch, lives in apartment 803. Sure, I got the film.
What's the story? I'm guessing she didn't stop for light refreshments.
She made a call. Sounds like Mark Bishop has a heap of trouble headed his way. I've got an address. Wilson's Hotel, apartment 803.
Oh, shit. You better step on it.
If he's got any sense, he'll be as far away from home as possible.
If he had any sense, he wouldn't have tried pumping up Guy McCaffrey's wife in the first place. Or he'd done the job properly. McCaffrey will break a fella's legs just for looking at you.
What did you make of the kid? You believe her story? I think she was doped out of her tiny mind and given the casting couch. That fucking bitch Ballard sold her out.
So if Ballard was doing someone a favor, why did they try to kill her?
All units in the vicinity in car 11K, 11K. A 415 in progress at apartment 803, Wilson's Apartment Hotel, 1220 West 7th Street, Westlake Park, 11K code 3, all other units code 2, KGPL clear.
Gun it! Let's get to the apartment before someone gets hurt.
Cops? I tried to stop them. It's room 803, left out of the elevator.
Sounds like we're about to make it a hat trick of hysterical female witnesses.
Look, lady. You want to pose your husband.
Give it up, LAPD!
I curse you and your children.
I love it when they don't come.
Oh, keep swinging. I like a nice breeze.
Are you injured, Mrs. Bishop?
I'm all right now. Those horrible, awful men.
Perhaps you should sit down, ma'am.
Yes. Yes. Forgive me, officers. I'm very flushed. I'll just sit down for a moment.
That's perfectly normal, ma'am. Take a moment while we look around.
Yes. Thank you. Just look at this mess.
Great Wall of Babylon. A replica of a replica. What do you have to do to earn $20,000? Presented to Mark. Looks like we found our mermaid. Who are these men in the picture?
My husband, Mark, and Marlon Hopgood. They work together on occasion. That's Hopgood's shop.
Looks like the old movie set downtown. Those men, I think they work for Guy McAfee. Do you know the name?
No. Why should I?
June Ballard is married to Guy McAfee. Have you heard of her?
That slut. She's been badgering my husband for days.
Mrs. McAfee alleges that your husband tried to kill her and her friend last night. I think you should tell us what you know.
My husband's a movie producer. This has something to do with his new picture. He doesn't include me in his business.
June Ballard said she had a deal to be in his new picture.
Mark repeatedly told her no. He had Joan Leslie lined up for the role. That's how he got the finance. June made all kinds of threats. She was very rude to me.
You know June Ballard?
We were both on the same picture a few years back. That's how I met my husband.
Where can we find your husband, ma'am?
He told me he would be on set. That's all I know.
Either we find him or McAfee's people do, Mrs. Bishop. If you care for him, you should make sure that we find him first.
I do care for him. But I don't really know where he'd go if he were in trouble. Hopgood might know.
Why is your husband paying Lorna Hopgood $20,000?
Lorna? Marlon's ex-wife? Are you sure?
You're lying, Mrs. Bishop. It's some kind of payoff. You know exactly what the money is for and who it's getting paid to.
Do I? Would you like to prove that, Detective?
Your husband looks like he's being blackmailed. They obviously have something on him if he's prepared to kill to cover it up. Why is the payment going to Hopgood and not McAfee?
Lorna works at a check-cashing place in Hollywood. You need to ask Hopgood why he needs that much money in cash.
Your husband was at a casting yesterday with a young girl?
Not that I know of. He told me he was looking at locations. The picture's been cast.
Jessica remembered a mermaid. The mermaid on the front of the prop store. You better come clean with me.
This is a sick town, Detective. Are you sure you really want to know? The truth is, my husband likes them young.
And you think that's okay?
I was 16 when I first met him. I thought he was a genius, a magician with film. I was 20 before I realized he was just a B-movie hack. But he's nothing compared to some of the monsters at these big studios. My guess is Ballard sacrificed her little friend. Happens to a lot of girls.
Your husband is in trouble. It could go easier for him if you were more helpful, Mrs. Bishop.
He's a big boy, Detective, and so are you. This is Hollywood. There's always a deal to be done.
Operator, message for KGPL.
Putting you through now.
Phelps, badge 1247.
How could I help, Detective?
I need a location on a silver screen prop store.
Just a moment. Silver screen props, corner 3rd and Figueroa.
Thanks for your help. Aging movie star, a wannabe starlet, and movie producer's wife. We're finally rubbing shoulders with the almost rich and famous. And from the stories they've given us, clearly none of them can act.
Mrs. Bishop knows more than she's letting on.
She doesn't seem to realize how much trouble her husband is in. The LAPD are the least of their worries right now.
Yeah. You'd think she'd have gotten the hint after those hatchet men redecorated her apartment.
Maybe she's just loyal.
Or she's in on it. She didn't seem like your average giddy broad with nothing between the ears.
Well, she might just be trying to buy enough time for Bishop to put a couple of oceans between him and the captain.
Phelps and Bukowski, LAPD. We are investigating the attempted murder of June Ballard and Jessica Hamilton.
Oh, Christ! I'm Marlon Hopgood. How can I help?
You hold castings here?
How'd you hear about that? I got a little soundstage out back.
Lead the way. Keep him here, Stefan. I'm gonna take a look around.
What's this got to do with me?
Don't try my patience, knucklehead.
Hmm.
doping a 15-year-old kid and abusing her in a screen test. What is wrong with these people? Turn off the lights, Hopgood.
Why would I want to do that?
Humor him.
One-way mirrors. There's a room on the other side.
Huh. Well, well. Find a way into that peep den, Phelps. I'll stay here and keep our pervert company.
And I have to call you back. I got some business here.
Sit down, Courtney. This is Mickey. Mickey, this is Courtney Sheldon. What would you like to drink?
Scotch. Straight up. I hear you're back at school learning to be a doctor, kid.
Yes. That's right, Mr. Cohen.
So you want to be a doctor and a dope peddler. Interesting combination, huh?
Do we have a problem, Mr. Cohen?
We might have. Yeah. Selling your dope to my boy Lenny looked like a good move, but Lenny has been supplying, wholesale, so to speak. The Bindle boys in this town aren't used to the juice without a little of the middleman taking his cut.
Lenny promised that wouldn't happen, Mr. Cullen. And Lenny works for you.
What can I say about Lenny? Let me think. Oh yeah, he's a putz. And he's lazy, and he's greedy, but he's my wife's brother. How can you make a cake with those ingredients, huh? Please.
So how is that my problem, Mr. Cohen?
Well, kid, the only way we're going to be able to make this work is to do some repackaging. We need to get the dope out of those dinky little cardboard boxes and...
Surettes.
Yeah, surettes. Great. We can put it into a big vat so we can water it down a little bit.
I won't bore you with the chemistry, but it doesn't work that way. You're likely to kill even more people.
Okay, listen. I want to buy you out, kid. I'll offer you $50,000. Hey. Hey! You don't like my offer? The Sheldon kid? I think I want him dead.
Jungle Drums, 8th and Francisco. Attention, Mark Bishop.
So what happened to the film of Hamilton's screen test? Thank you. You ever do any work for Mark Bishop?
Mainly do work for the studios. RKO, Republic, Warner Brothers. So yeah, when Bishop is doing work for a studio, yes.
When did you last see him?
Now I'm doing work for his next picture. Still pre-production though. Haven't seen him around here in a while.
I know you're lying, Hopgood. Bishop was here, and you know exactly what he was doing and what he left lying around afterwards.
You come in here without a warrant, and now you start throwing your weight around?
A 15-year-old girl told me how she was drugged and molested at a casting house. I found the chloral hydrate in your drinks cabinet. You give me something or I will break your fucking jaw, Hopgood.
Bishop was here with June Ballard and the girl. A lot of producers and directors use this place. I'm not responsible for what goes on here.
McAfee's men are looking for Bishop. We need to find him first. Any idea where he might have gone to ground?
If he really tried to kill McAfee's wife, my advice to him would be to leave town.
You're delivering props to Jungle Drums on 8th Street?
Bishop is using that old rundown wreck of a set. That place is dangerous. But it might be a good spot to hide.
What's the deal with you and June Ballard?
Look, buddy, I make props. I hardly ever meet the talent unless it's something tailor-made for them, like a sword or something.
You and Ballard are blackmailing Bishop. That's why he cracked.
You got nothing on me. My hands are clean on this.
Enough. I've been in your peep room, Hopgood. I've seen your smut pictures and the camera setup. You made a movie of Jessica. I found the canister.
The deal is I get to sell the movies to burlesque houses and private collectors. These movie guys love seeing their cocks on screen, but part of the arrangement is I never film their faces. June had me film Bishop, and then she kept the movie for insurance. He went apeshit when he realized his face was front and center.
Who has the film now?
Who else? McAfee.
Ballard had what she wanted. Where does the money come into it?
What money?
Enough of the lies.
I told you, I get my cut selling dirty movies.
Your ex was getting 20 large from Bishop.
If I wanted to skim 20 from Bishop, we'd do it through the movie budget. June said she'd sell him the film once the movie had wrapped, but Guy wanted cash. He's in a cash-only business. You think I had a choice in this?
That's all for now, Hopgood. We're taking you in.
Phelps! Roy Earl, add Vice. Hold on a moment. This is clearly a Vice case. You've been roughing up my informant?
Hopgood is a Vice informer?
Yes, he is, Phelps, and a very important one. Look at that mug. Have you been upsetting these two officers, Marlon?
So we just drop it?
You do if you know what's good for you. You need to catch the movie producer before an angry husband does, from what I'm hearing.
I'll be making a full report to the captain, detective.
You do that, kid. We're all very impressed with you. Let it slide, Cole. Let's get out of here.
Detectives!
Johnny Goldberg, you work for Mickey C.
That's right, detectives.
You wouldn't happen to know the guys who roughed up Mrs. Bishop earlier today by any chance?
No, no, not us. We don't do that kind of thing. It's the husband we'd like to talk to.
This is a police matter. You don't want to be taken in for obstruction of justice, do you, boys?
You could try the obstruction rap, but it won't stick. We could beat that.
You've had your 10 cents worth, gentlemen.
Bishop knows how the world works. Mrs. McAfee hits him up for a movie part, happens every day. But Bishop takes it a step too far and tries to rub out Mrs. McAfee. Naturally, Guy is gonna get upset.
What made you think Bishop would be here?
We figure he might be planning a little accident for Hopgood, too. Those two guys have got some unfinished business. You let us know if you find Bishop. Guy McAfee can be a very generous man.
I'm only going to warn you once, gentlemen. Stay out of this. This is a police matter. We will be bringing Mark Bishop into custody.
At least he's polite. Kind of dumb, but polite.
But I'm a lot less polite, you smug son of a bitch. So let me put it in ruder terms that even a pair of blockheads like you might understand. The only reason that you don't have bars on your windows already is because you're small fry. And we don't waste our time on small fry. You stay away from Bishop, and you stay away from me. Is that clear enough for you, asshole? Now run along back to your boss so we can pat you on the head and tell you what good boys you are.
I don't think they like your little pep talk, Bukowski.
Oh, shit! Get us out of here! They really don't want anybody getting the Bishop before they do.
Lay into his wheel arches. Come on! I can't take the shot from here, Cole.
We need to lose those fools, Phelps.
See him chase us now. Onto the movie set, Phelps. Let's roll.
Oh, Christ. And they say working traffic is like watching paint dry.
You know how to piss people off.
Hey, if they're prepared to gun down cops in broad daylight, McCaffrey really means business.
Seems like we're the only ones who want Bishop alive.
I have a good mind just to let him go work on the son of a bitch. I'm about done putting my life on the line to protect some child molesters.
That's our job, unfortunately. They don't get to dole out the justice.
There's the slippery bastard now.
No. God damn it!
Mark Bishop, stop! LAPD! Get him, Phelps. I'll cover the exit.
11K calling KGPL, the first assistance at 8 in Francisco, the abandoned movie set. My partner is pursuing suspect on foot. Code 3, KGPL.
I'm trying to help you, Bishop. This is all a big mistake.
It's us or McCaffrey's boy. Your choice.
Hands in the air, Bishop. Move another inch and you're dead.
Mark Bishop, you're under arrest for the attempted murder of June Ballard and the rape and attempted murder of Jessica Hamilton.
All right, I'll come quietly. Just don't kill me. If you found me, then McAfee's goons will too. Oh, we need to get out of here.
All right, but you stay close. Any tricks, and I'll save McAfee's boys the trouble.
Follow me. I know another way out of this place.
Christ, detectives, they're trying to kill me!
Last chance to back the hell down. It's this way.
McAfee doesn't make the rules. You hear me? There's no way out of here. I thought you said you knew where you were going.
We have to jump for it.
LAPD, you're making a big mistake. Find some cover!
Kill a cop. Come on,
and it's the electric chair.
Is this really the best McAfee's got?
How long do you think you can hold out?
You have to get me out of here! Just get after there. There's a ladder leading to the ground.
This is what I call a result. Mark Bishop, erstwhile film producer, an all-around piece of shit, catches a fast ticket to Quentin for statue rape and attempted murder, so he gets to spend the next 15 years playing sissy instead of sticking it to little girls. That is justice with a capital J, Detective Phelps. You've developed such a reputation, I'm not going to be able to hold on to you any longer. You're getting promoted. Go on, get your new assignment. It was good working with you, son.
Phelps. Bukowski,
this your work? Can I help you, Detective?
Sorry, Cap. Didn't see you there.
Yeah, I'll bet you didn't.
This is a traffic case. You need something?
I'm here to buy a drink for the two LAPD traffic cops who broke the back of Guy McAfee's private army. You don't have a problem with that, do you, Captain?
Go right ahead.
Get in. I'm buying. You'll like this place. A lot of movie people hang out here. You like jazz, Cole? The hopheads love it.
Sure, I guess.
Big bands and swing, I can understand, but this bebop palaver? How are you supposed to dance to that? This is Phelps, Leroy. Be nice to him. You'll like this place. They treat you right.
Like a table, Leroy.
What do you think we want to do? Stand at the bar like
I'll
chumps?
I'll get a table ready for you.
Don't look so happy to see me, Alphonse. I might get the wrong impression. Cole, this is Alphonse. He's a French Negro from Africa. Can you beat that?
The Congo.
A pleasure to meet you, Alphonse.
Is Elsa singing tonight?
Yes, she is. She has the next set.
Come on, Cole. You can meet Elsa while they're fixing us a table. You'll like her. She's something else.
Maybe another night, Roy. She's pretty beat up about it.
Get your hands off me. Don't ever tell me what to do or what not to do, Alphonse. You got a nice club here. Don't spoil it.
If you will follow me, detectives. Just through the door.
It was my only real friend, Harlan. We went through it all. Do you realize what he meant to me?
Of course I do.
You have no idea. You said it was construction work.
It was an industrial accident, Elsa. How can I be held responsible?
Elsa, are you going on?
Louis, for God's sake, he was my best friend. The only man who ever loved me without putting his hands on me.
Hi, Elsa. Here's someone I'd like you to meet. Cole Phelps, war hero and crime fighter extraordinaire.
And why would I want to meet another fascist from the LAPD?
Sorry about this, Cole. What an evening I'm having. First a Negro puts his hands on me, and then this. Who do you think you're talking to, you German junkie whore? Don't you ever forget your place with me again. Do you hear me? Evening, Doc. How's business?
Sanguine. Louis, help me here. I'm gonna have to give her something before her performance.
Blow it off, Cole. These artsy-fartsy types always get a little flighty. Meet Dr. Harlan Fontaine, doctor to the stars. Mr. Fix-It to the mental wreckage of Hollywood. So what about that drink, boys?